to silent mode during the show, and can we ask you not to use cameras with a flash? Now, please remember to cheer the goodies and boo the baddies as loud as you can, as it's time for Whittington Rocks.
I'm kitchen.
Just the right with hope and ambition.
You're stretching, trying not to lie.
I'm so good enough that my heart is pumping. Cause the homeless life doesn't give me much enjoyment. All this work, it drives me crazy. Rather to step out and misbehave. Butlins always got the stress on. Angry fat love with it rest on. Wish he'd just chill out and have a shave.
Where is that lazy boy? I'm breaking 9 to 5.
Friends, I thought that there are rumors that the men go up just to see my master rumors try a fresh green cake. Open up and then you shove it.
Tomorrow. Oh, I can't wait. And can I just say, you look beautiful today, Mum.
Oh, thank you.
Beautiful! Christina!
I will have you know, when I came out here, there was a man over there said I looked sexy.
No, Mum, he said you look 60.
Well, that's good enough for me, love. Anyway, it's been years since your father died, and I've decided it's time I found myself a new man.
And I'll tell you what, girls.
Have a look! Oh, there's some right dishy dads out there, isn't there? Oh, look, look, look. Oh, you're gorgeous. We got down there. Oh, you're gorgeous. All right, mate. I get that move, that's going to put me off now.
Hey, Mom, have you tried that new Tesco dating website?
Tesco dating website?
Yes, any man that picks her gets a bag for life.
I will have you know I am a slim and attractive woman. I've lost weight, girls. Oh, yeah, I've slimmed down to 12 stone and a few pounds.
How many pounds?
97.
Oh, they're getting everywhere these days.
I know, the bakery's overrun with them. I blame that nasty king rat.
Oh, if only there was someone with something that could scare them away.
Well done, Tommy!
Hurrah!
He just scared that rat away.
Oh, what a fabulous little cat. Hello. And who are you, young man?
Well, I'm Dick Whittington.
Hubba bubba! He is cool!
Gorgeous! Hello, Dickie. Call me Dickie. Where have you been all my life?
He wasn't born for most of it, but shut up.
Well, Dickie, I was just saying, I never expected to meet such a pretty girl.
Oh, don't say any more. I like to call this my national lottery dress.
National lottery dress?
Yes, if your numbers don't come up, at least you're guaranteed a rollover.
It's so embarrassing, he was talking about Alice.
Really?
Yes.
She's got a lot of makeup on, you know. That was Dog Ruff at 8 o'clock this morning. You look really close, it's like Peppa Pig in a wig. Not being funny, but I think she might be a man dressed as a woman, which frankly I find weird.
Mom!
I'm only joking. Of course I'm only joking. I'm not.
Now, Mum, Dick and Tommy have no money and nowhere to sleep.
Oh, pay attention, boys and girls, the plot thickens.
And we wondered if we could get a job in your bakery.
And how did you know it was a bakery?
Well, as I looked through the window, there was a giant sponge pudding just full of currants.
You saw a giant sponge pudding full of currants? Well spotted, Dick. Yes. Oh. I'm here all year, thank you.
Having a cat like Tommy around would really sort all these rats out.
Yes, and Dickie can look after the shop whilst we're enjoying your birthday surprise! A holiday on a cruise ship!
A cruise ship?
How exciting!
Yes, we set sail tomorrow morning on the HMS Butlins. Now, I must go and sort out my holiday clothes. I will definitely need something nautical.
Boom!
Hey! What did you just shout bum for?
It was a naughty call.
Oh, no. Idiot. Oh, Dickie, before I go, do you fancy a quick game of hide and seek?
Hide and seek?
Yes, I'll go and hide, and if you can find me...
You can give me a snog.
Yeah, but what if I can't find you?
I'll be in the cupboard under the stairs. Have everybody work to be done.
Fancy!
Working, Jack.
But I'm sure all the boys and girls out there would love to be in your gang.
Oh,
see?
Boys and girls, would you like to be in my gang? That's great. So this is what we're going to do. Every time you see me, I'm going to shout, "All right, gang!" And you're going to shout back even louder, "All right, Jack!" And then we're going to do my secret hand signal like this. Can you do that? Great! Let's get a practice in. You ready? All right, gang!
All right, Jack!
Boys and girls, that was really good. However, I know that the mums and dads can be a lot louder and a lot more sillier than that. So I'll try that again. You ready? All right, gang!
All right, Jack!
Brilliant! Now, come on, Tommy. I'm going to tell you a story about a cat in a high street chemist shop.
A cat? In a high street chemist shop? Well, what's it called?
Puss in Boots. Thank you.
Oh, Alice. Luck is slowly changing and my life is rearranging.
Thank you, Alice, for everything you've done.
Dreams and plans are in the making, life.
London town will all fall down beneath my
chocolate fudge. One more slice for you, Papa. Have a try, my homo stole your cheesy fruit and plain. Cherry, bacon, pasta slices at the lowest prices. Bag of milk and Mars, a pan of chocolate brownie fizz. Tiramisu and coffee, get to end with coffee. And a Belgian bottle, fruit and flame. Mayonnaise, cottage loaves and baguettes, and the frozen crackers. Blue is white or brown or brandy or wholemeal bagels. Brioche and ciabatta, bitter and focaccia. We're the best in town!
Sponges, bakery, you'll get the best in town.
You know, I do love being my own boss, but the admin and the paperwork can be a nightmare. Only this morning, I got an email about pork luncheon meat.
You got an email about pork luncheon meat?
Yeah, I thought I'm not opening that. It's probably spam. I think. Oh. You don't take one.
All right, gang!
I've just been shopping for ingredients. Do you know, I was in a budget supermarket and I saw a naked man.
You saw a naked man at a budget supermarket?
Mm.
Was it Lidl?
I don't know, love, he had his back to me. Well, a third of the adults got it, that's not too bad.
But I'm so happy that I found you. I bought you a big bag of your favourites. Juicy raisins.
Oh, give me a hug, you know how much I love raisins. Oh, look at them, they're gorgeous.
Good son. Oh, they're lovely, I've got them for
golden. Eat them up.
Oh, they're lovely, I've got more than that.
Oh. Eat them all, mum.
Oh,
you know what, Mum? I'm so happy that you like them. I had to reach right to the back of the rabbit hutch to get those out.
You are a disgusting Do you know what, for that you can help me with this kitchen then.
Oh, Mum, do I have to?
Yes, you do. Now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, may I present my brand new computerized kitchen of the future. It's not telly, you can join in. I said kitchen of the future. Lovely. Now, the first thing we're going to do is test out the voice-activated flour dispenser.
So what do I do then, Mum?
All you have to do is ask for some flour and you'll get it.
Ask for some flour and I'll get it?
Yes, you'll get it all right.
Okay. Can I have some flour? Oh, Mum!
You know what happened, don't you? You forgot your manners. You didn't say please. Go and try again.
Okay, Mum.
Try again.
Can I have some flour, please? Happened again!
It's not difficult. All you got to do is say, can I have some flour, please, and get your head out of the way?
Oh, okay then, Mum. Can I have some flour, please, and get your head out of the way? Oh, right, let's get everybody on this. Boys and girls, do you think Mum should have a go?
Yeah.
Do you? The boys and girls seem to think you should have a go, Mum.
Well, I might as well have done it myself in the first place. But, hold on a minute. There's a bloke under here. You have to breathe in the 20 stone coming through here. That's it. Chuckling. I'm just ticklish. Sorry, I'm just entertaining myself. Anyway, can I have some flour, please? You blow through that, you're dead, mate. I said, can I have some flour, please? Oh, it's broken. Here, have a look down there, love. I think there might be a blockage down the pipe.
Okay, Mum.
Oh, for goodness sake, Casper, forget it, we'll do that later. Right now, this kitchen has got a very special cake mix, all right? Now, all the ingredients go into here, all right? The cake mix comes out of here, and we put it in the kitchens, which are here.
Mum, do you think this is going to work?
Work? This is pantomime, dear. What could possibly go wrong? Here we go, then. I shall pass you the ingredients, and you can drop them in. Oh, hold on a minute. What do you think, Dad? Look, Dawn French. Anyway. Flour.
Flour.
I think you think your arms are longer than they are, don't you, love?
Yes.
You might want to try that again.
Flour.
Hey. Sugar. Lovely. And butter.
Butter.
Don't chuck that in, you'll concuss him under there. That's it.
Egg.
Yum.
Oh, Mum, I'm so happy. You finally bought me my very own games console.
A games console?
Yes. I've always wanted an Xbox. If you like that, you're going to love this.
Here we go.
Xbox 360. Excellent. Cracking. Extreme.
Stop it. Put it in there. Come on. I've got one for you. Shout out to my eggs. Anyway, now, all the previous yours is funnier today, I'm very impressed. Anyway, all I'm going to do is turn it on, and they should start to work automatically. There we go, Bossy.
Mum, it's working.
What?
Mum, I just turned it off.
Oh, I don't think you can.
Mum,
I
don't.
Put in a tin now, put in a tin.
Put in a tin.
That's it.
Tin.
That's it. And another one.
And
tin.
Another one.
That's
the other one.
It's not supposed to do that. Oh, well, never mind. This will have something to go in the oven. Got that in there. Oven on! What?
Yeah. Do you think it's those rats interfering again, Mum?
It's probably that bloke under the counter.
No! It's generally the rats. We'll have to keep an eye out for them, won't we?
Yeah.
Boys and girls, if you see any rats, will you shout out and let us know?
Yeah!
What?
Come on, you can be louder than that. If you shout out and let us know.
Right, now, the cake's in the oven. Next thing we're going to do is mix up the
oven.
Well, what is it, boys and girls?
Well, where is it?
Now. All right, all right. Jump at it or have a look. Was there a rat, boys and girls?
Yes.
Oh, no, there wasn't.
Oh, yes, there was.
Boys and girls, only shout out if you see a rat, okay?
Yes. What is it, boys and girls?
A rat? Well, where is it?
Where? All right, don't panic, we'll have a look. Was there a rat, boys and girls?
Only shout out if you see a rat, okay?
Mommy, is it a rat, boys and girls?
Well, where is it?
It's behind you!
Behind us! All right. Don't panic. We'll go and have a look.
Wait,
you see, look. There's nothing there, is there, Mr. Rat? Ah! Oh, it's a rat! Quick, there's something to win it with. Hit it with something. It's coming, kind.
Mom!
What?
What is this?
Oh, that's a very special vegetable strainer I only use at Christmas time.
A vegetable strainer you only use at Christmas time?
Yes, it's my Advent colander. I thank you.
Mum, maybe we can use this frying pan.
Oh, good idea, love, yes. Oh, it's there, quick.
Sorry, Mum.
Oh, I just had an idea.
Careful.
I know. I think that next time I see the rat, I will nod my head and then you can hit it.
Yeah, that was a leader.
You want me to do what?
I said,
I will nod my head and you can hit it.
Should I do it, boys and girls?
Yeah! No!
Should I?
Yeah!
Okay then, Mum, I am ready!
Oh, here we go then.
Ow! It's there! Well, hit it!
Hey!
Hit it!
What?
Hit it!
Okay!
Oh, look at the state of me. Do you know, I look like a fat mystic. Oh. Well, fatter, have you seen it? Anyway, you here on purpose.
Oh, I am sorry, Mum, but you have to admit, it was rather funny, wasn't it, boys and girls?
Yeah! Oh, funny, wasn't it, boys and girls? Well, I'll show you funny, shall I?
You can do this one. Oh, it's hilarious.
Boys and girls, should I give Mum the spoon?
Yeah!
Should I?
Yeah!
Okay then, Mum, here you go!
And for that, boys and girls, it's a 4-foot Dalek.
Mum, this is stupid.
I know, look at the state of us. I think we'll have to go wash some of this off in the sink.
Good idea.
Here we go then. Water on! Oh! 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 Ah! Oh! Water on!
Yeah.
And Mum's so happy to know you're looking after the shop whilst we're away.
And Tommy's got those rats under control already.
Well done, boy.
Hey, Alice, I just so wish we could come with you.
Me too. But somebody's got to look after the shop.
And Tommy and I will do a great job.
I don't think I've ever felt this way about anyone before.
Neither have I.
I wonder where Mum's got to.
Oh, here you are! Here, Mums! Do you like the outfit, girls?
Yes!
Thank you, yes, I do love a ball gown. Anna didn't get it, you know. Oh, there was a terrible accident on the M25. A truckload of tortoises collided with a vanload of terrapins. I tell you what, it was a terrible disaster. Thank you.
If you hadn't insisted on trying on all your holiday clothes, I now know the difference between Mum in a bikini and a Christmas tree.
Well, what is the difference between Mum in a bikini and a Christmas tree?
A Christmas tree looks better with the lights on.
Now, Mum, Dick and Tommy have come to wave us off.
Oh, Dickie, how thoughtful of you. Oh, you smell gorgeous. What's that?
It's the CK1. I just bought a bottle.
Oh, here, smell this.
Disgusting, was that?
KFC, I just bought a bargain bucket. Dickie, it's such a shame you can't come on this little holiday with us. We could have had a late night skinny dip.
More like a late night chunky dunk.
That is it! Give me the rest of our bags. Go on out with your tail, thank you. That's it, laugh it up, Pat, laugh it up. Do you know, I'm ever so excited, Tommy, because today I get to give Alice her next birthday surprise! Well, I'll tell you, on my 21st birthday, which was about 5 years ago, shut up, thank you, my mother gave me a diamond necklace, and today I get to give it to Alice! Yes, have a look at that. Anyway, gather around everybody. It's time for your next birthday surprise. All together now.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Hypnotize the finger. Look into my eyes and repeat after me. You are feeling really sleepy.
You make me feel really creepy.
You cannot leave my evil spell.
I can't believe how much you smell.
In my trance, you will fall beneath.
Oh, my, you could have brushed your teeth.
Enough! Take the necklace from your bag. It's time to cause some grief. They'll think Master Whittington is a dirty common thief. And now it's time to board the ship with all the other cruisers. My rats will not be far behind me. See you later, losers.
Here we are, Alice, dear. Your next birthday surprise. Your grandmother's diamond necklace. My bag. It's empty. Someone has stolen it.
And look who that someone is.
Ooh, Dick Whittington.
No! Wait! I don't know how this got there. Listen, I've never stolen anything before, I promise.
Boys and girls, did he steal the necklace? Did you say no?
Yeah!
Well, they said yes!
What?
You heard it.
We heard it suggest that you, Master Whittington, are nothing but a common thief! I'm flabbergasted. My girl's never been so flabbergasted. I'm talking! Now, give me those keys. And I suggest that you and Dickie leave London and don't come back. You know, I'm so disappointed. I could cry. Ah!
Oh, my dress room's on the other side, isn't it? Oh, somebody get me a Jaeger bomb.
Energy, she is like a totes alone.
Now, Jack, listen.
Do one, mate.
Alice, you believe me, don't you?
Of course. But there's nothing I can do.
Alice!
I'm sorry.
Alice, wait!
We see eye to eye, me and you, Richard Whittington.
Alice, wait! Tommy, I really thought our lives were about to change. It looks like we just have to leave London and forget all about Alice. Come on, Tommy. Back to Gloucester.
Gloucester?
Let's go.
Here we go.
you people met. I know you're thinking that I'm rather fat.
I'm here to tell you every inch of me is fat from the bottom to the top. I'm telling you, ladies, don't worry about your size. I said, boys, like a little balloon, that ain't no lies.
That ain't no lies.
See, you know that secret of silicone body is gone and wrong.
So, what are you doing? I've got my skin. Get off. Because, you know, I'm all about the bass, so triple.
Oh, but Mum, I got confused. They shouldn't call it a poop deck.
Stop it. Don't have to check that one, love. It sounds wet. Anyway, it's yours from the cake after morning I've had. Do you know what, Tracy? I went to the shop on board earlier, and I bought myself one of those deodorant sticks. You don't have the eyes up here, love, all right? Yes, I bought myself one of those deodorant sticks. I've never used one before, so I had to read the instructions very carefully. It said, unscrew top and push up bottom.
Yes. Are you having fun?
Well, I suppose so. I just wish that Dick and Tommy were here.
But we are here!
And what are you doing here?
Well, I'm here to prove my innocence. You see, Fairy Bobells told me I'd be Lord Mayor of London one day. And it was King Rat that stole your necklace to try and stop me.
A likely story. Everybody knows there is no such thing as fairies.
You speak for yourself, love. There's at least two in the chorus to be spotted in mums and dads. Anyway, boys and girls, did he steal the necklace?
No!
Well, is he telling the truth?
Yes!
Oh, I'm sorry, the boys and girls wouldn't lie. Oh, do you know, I'm so sorry I didn't believe you.
Oh, he touched me. Alice, I'm so happy!
Come on, it's time we went back down to our cabin. After all, it's getting very dark out here. Oh, here we go. I said it's getting very dark out here. Thank you! Ridiculous. Now, come on, us to bed. Us girls need our beauty sleep.
Well, you best have a long lie in then.
I will have you know I am beautiful. Last night, I had the ship's captain banging and screaming at my bedroom door.
Oh, well, what did you do?
I had to get up and let him out in the end. Somebody else. I don't get it, you know. Your dad always said that I had the face of a film star.
Yeah, Shrek.
All right, Lord Farquaad. Thank you. Get off, dear, off.
Yeah, but I want to make the audience happy.
Exactly, love. Get off.
All right, gang. See ya. Come on, Tommy.
Good night, love. I love you, really. I'll come and tuck you in a bit. All right, Dickie, Dickie, do you mind if I just... Excuse me. Here, Dickie, if you're interested tomorrow morning, ask me round the swimming pool wearing my glass bikini top.
Your glass bikini top?
Yes, smash and grab. She's still here. Oh, well, I'll leave you two lovebirds to it, all right? Good night, you two.
Good night, Mum.
Good night, love. Good night, Alice.
Good night, Mum.
Good night, love.
Good night, Vicky.
Good night, love. Sweet dreams! Hashtag awkward. All right, I'm going to go. They're going to start singing now, boys and girls. Yes! It'll probably be flat.
Oh, I still can't believe that you're here. I'm so happy.
So am I.
I thought you'd leave London and never come back.
Alice, I had to come back and see you. And I promise, I'll never leave you again.
Forgetting about our younger years, there was only you and me. We were young and wild and free.
No, nothing could change what you mean to me. There's so much that I can say, but just hold me up. Cause I love it. Yeah.
That was good.
Yes! Oh, it's easier than it looked before. Oh, yes!
Who do you think you are? Mace?
Dunce!
Down a bit, love. Down a bit.
Don't call me mate, just Neil.
Okay. Who do you think you are?
I'm Neil.
Neil?
I am the great and powerful Alban, Sultan of Morocco.
Excuse me. Don't Trump in a turban. If you're a sultan called Alban, that makes you a Sultan Alban.
God bless these people! Oh. You shall join my harem of girls!
Yeah, but I'm not a girl!
That's debatable.
Oh, Jack, don't argue!
Oh, and don't forget that cat we found on the beach! I can use him to rid me of all those rats that are taking over my palace! Take them away! Oh, get out! Out! And you, my waxen beauty! Oh, I could cover you in fruit, jelly, custard, and cream.
Not fruit, jelly, custard, and cream. Well, I tell you now, mate, I won't be trifled with.
Oh, my God! Oh,
what are you doing? Oh, don't! Oh, stop! Oh, don't stop!
So, they survived the storm. Washed up on the beach, all soggy. Dick Whittington is alive. And so does that make you moggy. The Sultan's guards have idle Jack, the Dane, the Cat, and Alice. And as we speak, he's taken them to his Moroccan palace. Well, I ran ahead. I got there in advance. And with a palace full of rats, they just don't stand a chance. Once I am ruler of the world, I shall fulfill my dream to break your toys, crush your iPads, and poison your ice creams.
And I can be willy.
You are not
drunken moron!
Moron? For that, you will be punished! I will either burn you at the stake or chop off your head!
Oh, what a choice! Stake or chop?
Isn't that right, Tommy?
Excuse me. Who is this Dirk Whittington top?
It's Dick Whittington! Yay! I'm here to rescue everybody and take back my cat, Tommy.
Oh, I knew you'd get us out of here.
No one is going anywhere. Tommy is my cat now. I was overrun with the baby rat before I found him.
But Tommy can't possibly eat any more than two or three at a time. Look, as a team, Tommy and I will rid your entire kingdom of all the rats. And I guarantee they'll never return.
Okay then, if you can rid me of all these rats then, I will set you all free and give you half my fortune.
Aw, thank you, Your Highness. Look, I'll return to London, defeat King Rats, and take my rightful place as Lord Mayor.
Yes!
What?
They just will kill him. Do you hear that? His Batman's not coating, so yeah.
Only very well melts with you. She'd sort you right out.
Rattletail.
That is what I'll do.
Very
he won't be seen again. And like the dirty rat he is, yeah, he'll crawl back down the drain.
Yes.
No, I won't.
Yes, you will.
No,
you know, I haven't had a pet
since my hamster Gavin died. Oh. I do miss Gavin.
Jack, that is so sad.
Well, what did happen to Gavin?
Well, Gavin died after drinking a whole bottle of heartburn medicine.
Gav died after drinking a whole bottle of heartburn medicine?
Yeah. I still can't believe Gav has gone.
Yeah.
All right, guys.
Come on, Tommy.
See you, Jack. See you, Tommy. So, Alice.
Yes?
Will you marry me?
Oh, yes, of course I will.
Come here, then.
Right, set the stage. Are you ready?
What?
We'll try that again. Set the stage. Are we ready?
Brilliant. Hit it, boys. Here we go.
Here we are.
Clap your hands.
One show. I think we should do something we've never done in a Butlins panto before.
Ooh.
I think we should have
a singing and dancing competition.
Yeah, I'm off for a singing and dancing competition. We need two teams, so we're going to split the room in half just like this.
Lovely.
Anyone on this side? You're on my team. Is that all I've got?
Yeah. Of course it is. Well, this side of the room, you're the beautiful people, because you're on my side! And when I say Vicky, you say Sponge! Vicky! Vicky! Oh, yeah, I'm down with the kids, man, yeah. I'm on fleek, yeah. Anyway, right. I don't know what it means, it's on the internet. Anyway, now we're going to go head to head, all right? No, not with this wig on. Oh, you're being filmed there. Anyway, we're going to go head to head at the same time, all right?
Yes.
So sit nice and loud and dance like nutters. Here we go, hit it, boys.
Right, hey, nice, nice.
Here we go!
Oh,